Good afternoon. Welcome back to the BNH virtual event space. You are tuned into intro to Sportraiture with the queen of Sportraiture, who's going to teach you everything you know need to know about Sportraiture, Dani Mack. Dani Mack, what's going on?
You nailed it.
Repetition.
That's it.
Repetition. It's great to have you on. I want to send a huge thank you to Westcott and the team at Westcott, Mr. JC Carey himself behind the scenes there.
Thank you so much.
It's great to have you on. We're going to learn today. We're getting used to a new term. Sportraiture was news to me, everybody. That's why I had to repeat it, because I think I freaked out for the entire length of the green room session today, making sure that I was not going to trip up.
Yes, which made me feel better too, because it is my intro. It's like what the whole workshop is called, and I never use that word. So I was like, am I saying it wrong? So for those that use it, like, more power to you. But like, intro to Sportraiture, it doesn't flow for me, you know. So sports portraits, but we're gonna do it. And every time we say it, we're gonna have a drink. No, we're gonna make it a
there
game.
We go. Old-fashioned Louisville. There we go. We're bringing back everything.
Everything that nobody else knows about.
Inside jokes. It's going to be 1 hour of inside jokes. Maybe we'll get a couple tips in. And by the end, you guys are all going to be able to pronounce Sportraiture.
Let's do it.
Dani Mack, I'm going to turn it over to you. I'm going to be in the background here.
Okay.
But we'll get to some Q&A at the end. So I hope you guys do have some questions on Sportraiture. And we'll get to those at the end.
You know what's so crazy? I wasn't going to start with this, but Sportraiture reminds me of, I use this analogy sometimes when I do my workshops, right? There's chefs and there's cooks, right? So I consider myself a cook, all right? I'm going to serve you up the best wings that you want on a Friday night. And they didn't go to school for it. They're just like the hometown cook, right? And then there's the chefs. The chefs, like, they study the culinary arts and they go to school for it, and they open up these 5-star restaurants, and you're getting dressed up on a Saturday night. Now, in the photography world, I think that there are chefs and they speak the language and they understand the language. And then there's the cooks that don't necessarily speak the language, but they understand the language. I am your cook for the day. You are going to get the best wings from me. But
I like it. It's like home cooking.
Yeah. I'm gonna serve up some home cooking. I'm not gonna be so technical. I'm not gonna speak the language, the Sportraiture. I'm gonna keep it simple. But yeah, that's pretty much my analogy. I use it. I might reference it later. Who knows? But to me, it makes me know exactly where I am in my lane with this whole sports photography thing. So I guess welcome to, I would be like a pub, right? Beer and wings.
Yeah, let's go. Exactly. Not like a gastro, like the little Irish pub on the block that has like the wings and the chili that no one knows about, but they're like a 10 out of 10.
Yeah, everybody knows about. What do you mean?
Well, nobody outside of the neighborhood, right?
Yes. Yeah. I'm not a gastro pub. I'm not going to be something super fancy, you know?
You're not on a TikTok viral tourist place to check out list. If you know, you know.
Yes. I might be at make one of those Instagram reels where they're like the best hidden spots.
Yeah, and then you got a line out the door and no one can go there.
And then I don't know what I'm going crazy and I'm like.
Yeah, we're going to try to book you a year from now and it's going to be like, who are you?
There you go. Listen, it might happen. Let's
go.
There you
go. Sportraiture. Sportraiture.
Sportraiture. All that from Sportraiture. Let's go. Guys, we're just going to die with this name. Okay. All right. So should I share my screen? Should we get started?
Go for it. I feel like I'm distracting.
I could talk all day. See, when I have an interaction with people, this is my vibe. This is what I do. But to everybody that's on there, let's do this thing. Let's get started. And if you guys have questions, we'll probably be answering it at the end. So just ask away and let me begin. Okay. I'm gonna share my screen. I'm gonna do this real professionally. Okay. We gotta go here. And we'll start it. Okay, here we go. Here's that word. Boom. Intro to Sportraiture with Dani Mack. So guys, I am Dani Mack of Dani Mack Photography, located here on Long Island, New York. So it is awesome to be doing this with B&H, who's New York based. My people, let's go. And I want to thank Westcott for having me for Westcott Wednesdays. And for all of you who are attending, especially those have reached out to me to tell me that they're attending today. Thank you. So let's get started. I want to just go over what I will be going over. So when I was writing this out, every word was like writing C, confidence, choices, this. So these are my 7 C's of success, which also sounds weird. But here we go. The first thing I'm going to be going over is confidence. You have to believe in yourself. This is just in life, but especially in business, because you're always going to sometimes just need the constant reminder that you got this, you could do it. I'm going to talk about your circle. This is super important. The people that you surround yourself with, the people who want to see you win. We're going to go over content. I'm going to talk about social media, how it's played a role in my growth with my business. I'm going to talk about continued education, mentorships, and workshops. Commitment, that is literally just saying yes. Collaboration, I'm going to touch upon how I work with my athletes. And last, I'm going to go over choices, specifically what Westcott gear I use, and of course, my other gear that I take with me on my photo shoots. So let's get started. Confidence, okay? Confidence, the definition of it is simply a belief in oneself. Mindset is everything. I'm very big on this. I like listen to motivating things. I'm a huge David Goggins fan. If you don't listen to him, like he will just make you feel unstoppable. So the mindset to just know that you could do it will get you through a lot of things. This is me. This is my favorite quote. I live by this quote. This is the foundation of my business. So if you guys get absolutely nothing out of this entire workshop, take a screenshot, do what you have to do. You could crop my picture out of it. But to me, your smile is your logo. Your personality is your business card. And how you leave others feeling after having an experience with you becomes your trademark. To me, when I am working with people, it's not just about pictures. It's not just about the photo, okay? It is about the overall experience. So if I'm like, to put it in terms of food, since I'm a cook, if I'm building that sundae, right? Like, smile, we're about to have the ice cream, we've got the sprinkles, and the cherry on top is the photos, but everything else makes for this total package. So for me, I have to have this experience with my athletes, their parents, and I'm in the business of creating memories. So it starts automatically when I first meet them. With that being said, let's get into the story of how I got into photography and sports. So it started with the belief in myself. To be honest with you, like so many, COVID was a tough time and I actually lost my job. So I went from having it all to feeling like I lost it all in one day. These days were very, very dark, guys. Like if anybody's lost their job or feeling like they literally don't know what they're going to do with themselves, I've been there. And to me, I had to pick myself up. But I wanted to just point out that I put the word feeling in pink because the truth of the matter is that I really didn't lose anything. I lost financial stability and that I knew I'd figure it out, right? I still had the belief in myself. I still had my family. And to me, that was everything. I knew that I wouldn't fail. Sink or swim, I'm swimming. I had confidence in myself. So if you ever find yourself in a situation where you think everything's been taken away from you, and I felt this, wholeheartedly felt it. It was not a good time for me. The one thing that got me through was the fact that I knew that I would make it. So here we go. For me, photography was my therapy. I always loved photography. I always had a camera. And I literally just picked up my camera as an outlet and decided to post a picture of my dog. This is a true story. I posted a picture of my dog on Facebook and someone reached out to me for me to take pictures of their family. Now, I don't know. I didn't ask any questions about why a picture of my dog would spark like, hey, do you want to take my family photos? But you know what I did? I said yes. And you'll see this as a common theme in the way that I do things. I say yes, and then I figure it out later. So from that, Dani Mack Photography was born. And a few more people reached out for photo shoots. And I was taking a lot of family photo shoots during this time. But that didn't cover the bills. And I desperately needed to cover the bills. And so I went on job interviews. Guys, I went on a lot of job interviews. This is me on my way to a job interview, right? So I had all dressed up. I had my briefcase on. And last minute, I just wanted to take a selfie. And at this time, like I said, Dani Mack Photography was getting going. I picked up my camera and you know that it's countdown 10, 9, 8. And I just pointed to the camera because the truth of the matter is that on all these job interviews, they were offering me the job, but they weren't going to pay me what I was being paid. And I just was like undercutting myself. And here I was, I wasn't making the money yet with photography, but if I'm going to take a job for less money, I might as well put it all on me. So in this moment, I chose me. I knew that I was just going to make photography work. So I'm really happy that I took that picture. Hindsight's 2020. It's a pretty cool shot. And I liked my outfit too, just on a side note. So in the beginning of Dani Mack Photography, I literally said yes to everything. So here are some of the images from when I got started. And I'll have you know, everything was natural light. I never picked up a flash ever. So this was just a family portrait session. And yes, guys, that's me with the red hair. That's my first behind the scenes photo somebody took. I liked it at the time. Let's just talk about my hair for a second. I really, really liked it. Okay. No one else in my family did, but I liked it. Very high maintenance though. This second picture here, a cookie company reached out to me for branding. So yep, say yes, sure. Yes, I do that. I took Christmas photos. I took like editorial beauty pictures. This picture right here, this company actually is a communion. They make communion dresses and they just launched communion sneakers for the girls, which I kind of dig. I think that's awesome. So this was for their sneaker campaign. This picture might be the first inkling that I was going to go into sports. This little girl was not into wearing the dress for her communion. She is more of like a sneakers, cleats, pants type of girl. So I told her, let's go grab one of your cleats. Let's take a cool picture for you. And then like I took baptismal pictures. This is where I was. This is what I was doing in the beginning. So you might be thinking like, all right, so how'd you get into sports? Well, in April of 2022, and I want you to pay attention to the date, right? April of 2022 is when I got started. So it's, you know, it's almost 2 years ago. That's it. So hold on. Ready for the ride? I'm about to show you what happened. All right. In April of 2022, I was literally just a mom with a camera. And actually, it was an old camera. And I want to just give this piece of advice. I was using my Nikon D3200. Don't stress about the newest gear in the beginning. Just get started. I have had people reach out to me on Instagram like, hey, I'm a mom with a camera too. Like, what should I get? Like, just get out there and just start taking pictures. Guys, terrible picture of me. See that red hair? That's what happens when it's fading and then you have to maintain it. Ugh, whatever. Anyway, terrible picture of me, but this was me at my daughter's sports games just taking pictures. But you just get out there. What I decided to do since I wasn't into sports photography was I decided to send these pictures through the group chat that I was on. Now, if you are a parent with a camera, you know all about these group chats, right? You're on your kids in sports. This is my other piece of advice. If you're on these group chats, take this to your advantage, okay? These people might not be following you in your Instagram page if you're just getting started, but you automatically are in front of them. You have an audience of maybe 10 to 20 something parents at your fingertips. Send them the images. I'm gonna show you what I did. This is legit how I used to send the pictures in the group chat. And I would just write, oh, hey team, here are the pictures from today's game, enjoy. And I'd say, Dani, I never mentioned that I was a photographer. I never asked them to buy the pictures. I never asked if they wanted me to take their kid's picture. I added my watermark to the bottom. I felt like it would speak for itself. I didn't put it across their kid's face. I did all this on purpose. If they wanted to crop out my name, fine. I didn't want to push the fact that I was doing this, but I wanted, what if they did post it somewhere? What if somebody was like, who's that photographer? What if? So to me, the decision to do this changed the course of my photography business. But guys, that definitely did not happen overnight, okay? It's not something that you just send out and then all of a sudden you're getting booked. I would send these messages for months and I posted them on my Instagram. And still, no one was booking me for sports photography. It took time and it took patience and it took patience and time, which when I was doing this presentation just totally reminded me of this.
It's gonna take time, a whole lot of precious time. It's gonna take patience and time.
Sorry, I break out into song with a lot of things. So when I was typing it up, I'm like, that's the song, guys. It's gonna take time. It's gonna take patience and time. So just don't think that it just happens. Which leads me to my second C, which is circle. Okay. Now, your circle has to be people who are going to help you. They want to see you win. I touched upon that before. They support your business. No, listen, it's not to say that these won't be your family members, but sometimes the biggest shocker is that it's not necessarily people in your family or people you grew up with, right? Sometimes it's a complete stranger. And hey, it could be somebody on this webinar that will end up being in your circle and helping you out. This is an appreciation post. I remember the people right from the beginning that helped me out. And as I grew in this business, I put this up there for them. You know, your circle should want to see you win. They want to push you and they should be encouraging you. So your circle to me is very important. For me, the first person was my daughter's coach, Coach Joe. He was a complete stranger to me at the time. Our kids didn't go to school together. My daughter was just put on his team. But after sending him all these pictures and putting it on that group chat, he'd asked me, like, if I do this and this is like, do I do sports photography? And I told him no. And I told him that I lost my job and that it was like really difficult. And that was like a really dark place mentally. And he had sent me this quote and it changed everything for me. And I totally reference it from time to time on my social media. So if this relates, if you could like feel this quote somewhere, like it's beautiful. Sometimes when you're in a dark place, you think you've been buried, but you've actually been planted. The future looks bright. Now, he had sent this to me after we spoke about like what I was doing with my life as far as photography and work. And I just thought it was beautiful. See, he saw my potential. And after months of receiving the photos, he definitely was like, you need to be doing sports. So he helped me get my first paid sports job, right? Like I couldn't get it. It took somebody to help me. Hashtag planted, hashtag find your circle. I sometimes use the hashtag planted often because sometimes you think it's just not happening. It's just not happening. But don't worry, the seed's been planted. You just have to like find the people to sometimes offer you a little bit of water to get that just to sprout and bloom. His wife made me that cup. And so I'm appreciative of the support of that family. So here are the pictures from my first paid sports shoot in July of 2022. Now, if you remember, I said April 2022, I was just the mom with the camera. So just a few months later, like it took time. I got my first paid sports shoot, which led to my second and then my third. But I wanted to put this up just to show you. See the boy number seven? That was the coach's son. So the coach that ended up saying yes and hiring me for my first paid sports shoot. And I really thought like, this is how I'm going to get my second sports shoot. He's going to talk to other coaches. But actually, it was this girl on the right. Her dad was the one that booked me at that game before he even saw the pictures, booked me for the following weekend for his son's big game. And guys, this is totally off script, but this dad texted me today. I haven't heard from him in 2 years. He texted me today to book me for a photo shoot, like in the beginning of April. So, like, I sometimes find stuff like that, like bananas, but there we go. He just messaged me. So, thank you, Jeff. That is his name. So, he booked me for my second photo shoot. And I was just like, I can't believe this is happening. But if I have to relate it to anything, remember that quote in the beginning that I said you should screenshot where your smile is your logo and the way you make people feel? I definitely believe that that helps. Like, because when I go to these games, I'm definitely interacting with the parents that are in the stands. I'm asking them who their kid is. You have to get yourself out there, get out of your box a little bit. Game day action is very easy to just be a little sniper with a camera and not interact with anyone. And I love that about this type of photography. But if you're building your brand, remember who your audience is and who your potential clients might be. Always talk to the parents. So here we go. Amazing things has happened to me in my sports photography career, but the highlight happened on my second photo shoot ever, guys. This is a true thing, and I have to like tell you the story. So I got this job from the dad and I had to go find the field that I was working at. I never met the coaches, no nothing. Should I like stop sharing my screen for story time? Like
Whatever you're more comfortable with,
I
we'll
don't know.
take either way.
All right, I don't know. It is what it is. We'll just keep going. So as I'm walking to the field to like meet my team, this guy just stops and poses because he sees me with my camera. He literally strikes a pose. I'm a photographer, so I take his picture. A stranger to me. We don't know each other from a hole in the wall. We don't even speak. We have a good laugh, and I carry on my way. I literally go and I meet the coaches. I start taking pictures of the warm-up, and I see the guy I just took a picture of, right? And he goes, Are you taking pictures of this game? And I said, yeah, I am. He's like, oh my God, amazing, great. Number 13, that's my son. He's the best player. You have to take his picture. Like, I'm telling you, you have to. I said, okay, great. Like, awesome. So I look for number 13 and I realize he's on the other team. And I go, ooh, I'm so sorry. I like legit can't take pictures of your kid. Like the other team hired me. And he was like, how much? I'll pay you right now. What's your Venmo? He was persistent. And I was like, oh, it doesn't really work that way. But then like secretly, I'm like, aren't I my own boss? Like, does it work that way? I don't know. I was like, listen, how about if I get the opportunity to take a picture of your kid, I will. And I will give you a price for the picture tomorrow. Like, sounded great in my mind. And he was cool with that. He was like, all right, fine. We exchange numbers and we go about our business, right? And taking pictures of the games. Now, something magical happened. Okay. The stars aligned and I found myself in the perfect position to capture the incredible game-winning grand slam by none other than number 13. Okay. So of course, like the dad comes running up to me and he's like, oh my God, did you get the shot? And boy, did I get this picture? Here's an Instagram reel I made with the photos.
This is how we do. We make a movement at the fool while we up in the club.
Now, I'll tell you something. This picture was so special to me because I definitely would have never gotten that picture if I was shooting that team, just based on the fact that I usually would shoot from the other side of where the batter was like batting. But he hit this and then I got the team all came out. Like, it was the end of the game. I get the crowd in the background, the reaction of these little boys. It just was like amazing to me. I couldn't believe that I got that picture. And so when the team saw the photo, the coach from that team reposted it on his Instagram with a caption that literally made me cry. And honestly, I really hope that I don't cry like reading what he wrote, but hold on, let's see if I could do this. No, I can't see my thing. But he wrote like, sometimes pictures don't need a caption. You could just feel the energy. Like this quote, if you guys could see it, can you see it on your screen?
Yeah, we can see it up here.
Yeah.
There are times when pictures don't need an explanation or caption. You can just feel the energy from that moment. This is one of those pictures. Every little leaguer's dream.
Thank you for reading it for me. I have this thing on my screen, so I can't, but like, and I'm actually happy that you read it. I cry every time. And I think the reason why I cry every time that comes up is because like every time I read it, I was so new to sports photography. This happened to be like, this is my second sports shoot. And just to have somebody say that about like my pictures. And I felt that. I felt that when I captured it and he wrote that. And I was just like, it was beautiful. The whole town like loved this photo. Right. And I couldn't believe that I captured it. So there is that. Here we go. Okay. So needless to say that the coach then booked me for their next game. And guess what? They ended up winning that game that I was photographing. So I don't know how many of you guys on this workshop do sports photography for Little League, but there is a thing called Williamsport teams. Okay, so Williamsport is ultimately the road to the Little League World Series. So if you're shooting these teams and you get a team that is literally just 2 or 3 games away from heading to the Little League World Series, just a heads up, this might be a team that you want to just go out there and just start photographing. To me, I knew none of this. And then all of a sudden, here I was in the mix of it. And I was photographing this team that was on fire. They were on fire. It was amazing. So I made a reel from the pictures of that game and I put it up on Instagram. All right, so here we go. Which leads me to my third C, content, okay? I made the choice to start making Instagram reels regularly and tagging this team in this league, which gained me more followers and a few other teams hired me. Now, this was amazing. I was like, this is so cool. However, guys, with that being said, this team didn't hire me for the game, the state championship game. They didn't hire me after they won the state championship game for the big send-off that the town threw for them, right? Like, this was a big deal, right? And guess what? They didn't hire me to go to the regional game either. But I just was making content. I continued to make content with the pictures that I had from this team, and I made sure that I was there. That's right. I drove 3.5 hours to Bristol, Connecticut to watch them play, and I made sure I captured every moment for this team. And I made content out of every image. And I did all of this for free. Okay. Here are the two reels that I made for this team. The first one is from the big send-off of the town. I took pictures of cars. I took pictures of parents saying goodbye to their kids. It was amazing. And then the second reel, I had made posters for the boys on this team. And I had all these digital posters. So I was like, oh, as a photography company, I could wish them luck. Like, let me do something really cool on Instagram to wish the boys luck at the regional game. So here you go. You gotta love CapCut.
Last but not least, I want to thank me. I want to thank me for believing in me. I want to thank me for doing all this hard work. I want to thank me for having no days off. I want to thank me for never quitting. I want to thank me for always being a giver and trying to give more than I receive. I want to thank me for trying to do more right than wrong. I want to thank me for just being me at all times.
So I sent that. I put that on Instagram. The parents loved it. They were so appreciative of it. And other people like reposting it. So it was great. And guess what happened? They won the regionals. Do you know what happens when you win the regionals? You're off to the Little League World Series. And that's where they were going. And guess who they hired to photograph the game? Me! I was going to the Little League World Series. So you see all those free photos and all that time making the reels and all those hours, the patience, consistency. Wait, should I play the song again? Nah, I'm not going to do that. Guys, it paid off, right? Now I was off to the Little League World Series to photograph this game. It was amazing to me. But listen, if I thought that that was nuts, crazy things happen when a team makes it to the Little League World Series. Like, suddenly the New York Post was willing to pay me $500 for a photo I took. And not just any photo, this photo. Boom. There it is. A full page in the New York Post, right? And my name. Like, I was like, I couldn't believe this. I took this picture on my second sports photo shoot ever. And here it is in the paper. Like, that's a huge deal for me. Mind blown, right? And if I thought that that wasn't crazy enough, Billy Baldwin reposts it on his Instagram. Okay. And so I like freak out. I was like, I remember I was in my brother's kitchen. I was like, oh, yes, like Billy Baldwin, right? And then he wrote back. He responded. Like, it was a big deal to me, okay? Like, I felt like I've made it. Like, you know who I am. But, like, really, it was, like, nothing. It's the team, essentially. But I took the picture, and he wrote that it was a great shot. So I was on cloud nine, okay? And to be honest with you, this is actual footage of how I was feeling as my sports photography career was, like, gaining momentum. You know, just complete like, oh, this is so amazing. But yeah, like, I'm so scared. What's happening next? Now, listen, the team did not win the Little League World Series, but I captured history for the team and my town. And I was booked for months. Here's some of those pictures. I was pushing out content. Anyways, just taking pictures. I started making posters. I made baseball cards, 3D cutouts. This is when, like, I really went full in on my business and just making products, where I'm not really going to touch upon that in this workshop. But if anybody wants to reach out to me afterwards about, like, what I use and how I got into, like, the baseball cards, the banners, the posters, please reach out to me. So yeah, like, this is some of those pictures, girls softball, flag football. And then, guys, listen, remember Coach Joe who sent me that "you weren't buried, you were planted" quote? He sent me another text. Okay. Now, we all know the text. If you're in sports portraiture, sportsature, what is the word? Sportraiture. You know, the Brad Deal text, guys, you know, the one that looks like this. Like everybody's sending you these reels. And listen, apparently we're not the only ones, because here's James Quance Jr. talking about it in his most recent YouTube video with Brett.
A bunch of people that knew me, they saw your pictures and stuff, and then they sent it to me. It's like, have you seen this guy doing these photos? And I was like, no, I really hadn't. And then, you know, after the first handful of people sent it, then, yeah, you know, by the 20th person that sent right. it to me, I was like, yeah, I've seen this. Well,
so we're not alone, right? So needless to say, after I got this text from Coach Joe, I started following Brad Deal Sports on Instagram. And I watched every single one of his reels, like you probably all have if you're doing the sports portraits, right? And I wondered how he created these amazing images. And then I saw that he sold presets. So I was like, fantastic. I'll buy his presets and voila, magic, right? My images are going to look just like Brad Deal's. This is his preset grit. But yeah, no, that's not what happens. That is not what happens. Does make for a cool image, but my images didn't automatically look like Brad's because I bought his presets. Okay. Like not even close. So what I did was I contacted him for help. Like I emailed him, and do you know what he did? He offered me a refund. Okay. WTH. Because last I recall, I don't think he read my email correct. I was asking for help, right? And I didn't ask for a refund. So I kindly wrote him back. Like, I really like, that's nice. I don't want my money. I want to take pictures like you, right? And so he wrote me back. And from that day on, Brad Deal was my mentor. Okay, so lucky me. Which leads me to my fourth C, continued education, finding a mentor, okay? Or attending workshops like you guys are right now. This is so important for your growth. If you want to be successful, find someone who has achieved the results you want and copy what they do, and you'll achieve the same results. Now, Tony Robbins said this. He's pretty influential. I would take heed his advice, but I would throw a little twist of lime on it. I don't necessarily think you want the same results. You essentially want to get there, but like create your own lane. If I was going to add a little Dani Mack twist to it, you know what I mean? Not necessarily the same results, but just a little. I'll twist the line. Why not? All right. So I started my mentorship with Brad before I ever purchased my first flash. And the reason for this was because I needed to discuss what I needed to purchase. I didn't know anything. So he taught me how to use everything over Zoom. We discussed everything, and I would set up my lighting in my living room, and he would walk me through it step by step. I had to be both the student photographer and model. Now, I've mentioned this, if you guys follow me on Instagram, I've actually put posts up like no model, no problem. Like you guys sometimes have to step in front of the camera, learn the camera, set it up on a tripod, and throw yourself in front of it to see the images that you're getting. I definitely had to do this from time to time. And listen, is it intimidating? Yeah, because I'm doing this in front of Brad Deal. But listen, you have to practice to get better. And I had that mentality. So like, let's go. I had made the commitment to myself to learn. So regardless how awkward it was, and anybody who knows me knows I hate being in front of the camera. I prefer being the photographer, but I had to learn lighting. I had to do it. So I did it. And anybody that signed up for my mentorship, be prepared. You might be getting in front of the camera from me because you have to learn. This leads me to my fifth C, commitment. Say yes and then figure it out. You see, I'd already set up my first portrait session before my flashes even arrived at my doorstep. I was already pushing myself that this is where I was going, and someone hired me for the job. What I've learned in this business is if opportunity comes your way, take it. Just say yes. Trust in yourself. Have that confidence in yourself that you will figure it out. These are some pictures from my first paid shoot using off-camera flash. I have to say, guys, I love these images. I love them so much. I definitely know I would change a few things. To be honest, I went a little bit heavy with the clarity and texture. I would reduce that now. But I'm going to celebrate my wins. This was my first like session and one flash, that magic of one flash. And I was proud of myself. So if you're starting out, celebrate your small wins. This was a win for me. I went in there. I was new. And I did it. And all right. Having subjects like this, it wasn't that hard to work with. It wasn't a terrible day on the job. That did help. But, I was proud of the work that I did. So commitment and continued education go hand in hand. Now, the first part of commitment is saying yes to the job, but then you have to figure it out. And this is where education comes in, okay? So, and although I was meeting with Brad over Zoom, and I really wanted that hands-on experience, so I signed up for workshops like you guys are doing today. My first workshop that I ever attended was Brad's and Jason Sterling of Rocktown Media. They had a workshop in January of 2023 down in Florida. And I'll show you some of the pictures from that workshop. But it was very important to me to attend workshops. So if you want my advice on the top three workshops that I definitely think you should attend, obviously any workshop that I run. So pat you guys selves on the back. I mean, amazing. You're doing so good. So yes, number one is any workshop that I'm doing. Two, now Brad and Jason are calling their workshops the Light It Up Tour. Go on their Instagrams, definitely sign up for it. It's amazing. I would highly suggest the Light It Up Tour workshop. And I have to say, like, the Summit workshop, I attended the one in New York. It changed my life. This is where I met JC. I met Gene Fruth and Steve Fine, and they have been instrumental in my growth as a photographer. Each and every one of them definitely played a role, but like, if I could just take like 2 minutes just to like give a huge shout out to JC Carey for just so much. Let's just talk number one, introducing me to Westcott. So I am not going to touch upon this in this workshop, but I do volume photography as well. And when you do volume, you know, you have a ton of gear. So I was using a different brand. I have a ton of that other brand stuff. And in talking with JC, he was teaching me all about the magic and wonder of Westcott. And here I am using Westcott. I love their interface. I love their customer service. And so he introduced me to the world of Westcott, and it has been absolutely like life-changing. He is also an amazing human being who has taught me so much as a photographer. I was new, and he has literally like opened doors and given opportunities. So when I tell you about your circle and they want to see you win, surround yourself with these people, and they could be complete strangers who are now a part of your life. It's just, it's a beautiful thing. So shout out to JC. Thank you so much. It's why I'm here. So I just wanted to take that moment and say thank you. But listen, guys, truth of the matter is you're not going to learn anything at workshops if you don't literally go in with a plan. You have to get the most out of these workshops. You're there with other photographers. And if you know the sports that you're going to be shooting, then do your research and look up some poses that you want to do. Okay. You got to be different than other photographers. I want you to think outside of the box, because as far as I go, the instructors will show you the light placement, and they're going to have their athlete sitting there, and they're going to show you their pose. And what I have seen in doing these workshops is that everyone then takes the same picture of that athlete. But when you're out there and you're on the job, you have to interact with this athlete, and you have to think on your feet. And it's more than just one pose. So if this is your opportunity to be in front of a really, really skilled instructor, ask them for help. Now, for this picture right here, I was at the workshop with Jason Sterling and Brad Deal. I took this picture when I was working with Jason. I went in knowing that we were doing tennis, and I knew that, yes, I was going to get this typical tennis pictures, but I wanted a different picture. So I made her almost bite into the tennis ball as if it was an apple. And I think it came out really cool. I love this picture. Here's the reveal of that. So there you go. You have to think differently. So here's some of my top tips on how to think outside of the box. All right. Obviously, I talked about pose, but lens choice is a way to make your pictures look different and effects. So in that first picture of the lacrosse kid, I'm using a 14 millimeter lens. Now, I actually don't own this lens. My best friend's dad actually gave it to me, knowing that I was going to this workshop. He's like, use it if you want to. Right. So pretty cool. Got that. The pose, obviously, just something fun. And then the last one over here with the boy punching with the lacrosse, that is water in the back. So you can't always use smoke when you're outside because the wind will take it. Just a piece of advice. If you have a water bottle, look at the effect that you can get. And then with editing. So think about a bunch of different things to make your sportraiture pictures. You see what I did there? I threw it in there. you know, just stand out to me. Okay, lens choice. This is my 1635. I whip it out sometimes because I just love that wide angle, and I like the look that it gives my images. So the pose itself with just a different lens just might make it just pop. Poses, all right? Talk about the first one with the football kid. Obviously, I got this photo. I was inspired by some of Brad's pictures. I wanted to try it. Simply just having them make it like they're getting the ball from the center is a sick picture. The middle one here of this boxer, this actually was taken at the Summit Sports Workshop with JC, and all the sports photographers were taking pictures of this boxer inside the rink. He was sitting down, and I have all those pictures. But then I just asked JC, hey, would it be possible if I can get him, like, take the picture from outside of the ring? And he was down for it, like, let's go. And I got this awesome picture. And then that little girl, she brought all her medals, and a typical picture would probably be her standing there with the medals around her neck. Like, I've taken that picture a million times, but let's get her doing what she does best, right? She's a gymnast. And so we strategically placed all the medals and we got a different pose, and it's a cool shot. I love it. If you're on a field with dirt, would parents always ask me, what kind of field? Turf? I'm like, if I could do a dirt field, let's do a dirt field. Throw the dirt up in the air. Here in the middle picture, we got the ProLite mods. Those things just, they make your images pop. I love the ProLite mods. Smoke is an effect that you can use. A prop. The dad brought the weights. I don't bring weights to my photo shoots. God knows I have enough stuff to carry, but have these conversations with your parents for the photo shoots. And then my lacrosse kid, once again, having that water bottle on hand. Look how crisp that water looks. It's just a sick picture. Then we'll talk props, right? So the first picture over there of the musician, which was outside of my realm, which was so cool. I love that photo shoot. But I've told the mom to bring the music, like bring sheets of music. And we threw them up in the air and we used it as a prop. My gymnast here in the middle, I'm so used to photographing like my athletes that put eye black on. I asked her if she was cool with putting like the chalk on her eye. Just think outside the box. And then my last baseball player, this was actually a shoot for his bar mitzvah. They wanted to take pictures beforehand. And I asked the mom if she was cool with him bringing his suit because I love the suit with the sports. And so there you go. You just outside the box, right? Doesn't have to be so cookie cutter. And also, as a photographer, don't forget that you can move, right? So you can shoot high like this.
That I couldn't do it, so I went and did it. W's only, you know I've been winning. Top of the world, the globe is spinning, spinning. If you know, you know, I've been on a what mission? Mission. Go. Okay, let's get it. Got a little time on my hand.
And you could also get low, like shoot low. You want a really good shot? Lay on the ground. Get stuff like this. All right, you're not getting that by standing up. You got to get on that ground. And also, don't forget that the details can make amazing shots too. Sometimes it doesn't have to be of the person's like face or whatever, right? Like this picture alone of him holding this baseball was just awesome. The dad loved this picture. I think they blew it up in their house. Just a cool picture. And then this next one, look at the turf beads. Like that's sick. I love it. It just shows the momentum and the action. So don't forget the detail shots too. Now, listen, my 6C is collaboration. This is all about how you work with your athletes. So remember that quote from the beginning about leaving others the way that they feel after having experience with you? To me, that is the most important part of when you're working with your athletes, okay? These are my rules for working with athletes. And when I mean rules, because I'm like, oh, rules, whatever, it's just highly recommended suggestions, okay? Number one is to make it fun. Yeah, you're creating an experience, not just amazing photos. All right. And number two, and this is super important when we're working with athletes, they are not machines. Okay. So if you can't get the shot after a few tries, read the room. If you see that they are exhausted or no longer feeling it, just move on. Don't make them feel bad that either they're not getting the shot or maybe you're not landing the perfect timing. Just move on. Keep it light. This happens. Even with the best of sports photographers, sometimes it's just not going to happen. And that's okay. Number three is to demonstrate what you want. I am a firm believer in this, but I understand that some people feel like they look silly. Just do it anyway. And sometimes you just can't do it. And I understand that too. And if you can't do it, like you're definitely not going to like jump up in the air and like throw the ball and show them how what that looks like. Be prepared with a video of what that looks like. Like have it downloaded on your phone. Don't be scrolling through Instagram and wasting your time on on your session, just have it ready. And then my last rule is to show them the images, okay? Nothing builds confidence more than when a photographer is so hyped about a picture that they just took and they show the athlete like how awesome they look. I do this all the time. And like my presentation's like, oh, look at this, what we just got. It's like, it's cool. So anyway, I'm gonna show you a little bit of how I work with athletes.
Finish him.
Just showing you that I demonstrate.
You watch me work. Watch me work.
I just hit a home run. That ball out of here.
I have to demonstrate for them. And this one was fun to demonstrate. No, it wasn't, but I did it.
Everybody can't do this, which is why everybody don't do this, which is why we doing this.
Come on now. I mean?
Demonstrate.
Go! Show them how it's done.
And they like it. Like, I honestly, I think we have like the most laughs when I like try to show them something. And then I'm like, listen, I don't play this sport. Make it look better. But like, this is what I kind of want you to look like, but like not look like. It's funny. But listen, so collaboration is how I work with my athletes, but it's also about how I work with my parents, coaches, the schools, and other photographers. So every job that I've ever booked has been word of mouth, but my best advice is to be fair and stay firm. Now, I mentioned that it's been word of mouth because I do get Instagram messages from other photographers about how I am able to land these jobs in these high schools. Like, how did I reach out to the athletic director and all this other stuff? But I haven't. I have no experience. My work has spoke for itself. Word of mouth has gotten me these jobs. I feel very thankful for that. I have a beautiful community, and people like me. They really like me and my work. So that's how I've been able to land these jobs. But when I say be fair and stay firm, I'm talking about pricing. This is just my advice in this because it has bitten me in the behind before. Listen, if you price one team a certain price, honor it for the other team. I don't care if your best friend's kid is on the other team. Your reputation on being fair will far outweigh your work. People will talk, and I made this mistake in the beginning. So my advice is if you price the volleyball team at a certain price and the basketball team comes to you and they're like, you know, that's your homegirl and her kid's on the team. She's like, cut me a deal. Be like, listen, the volleyball team paid this price. This is what the price is, because it's only fair to the kids and the parents if you just keep it the same. And my next thing is this, because I've ran into this before too. If you are a photographer, don't bid lower than your competition. To me, that's just grimy, okay? We're setting the tone then that our work isn't worth the money, and that's not cool, right? If anything, come in with the same price and let your work speak for itself. Like I said, I've had this happen. It's not cool. I am definitely not in it for the competition. I'm in it for building community. If you guys don't follow Shot by Jasmine on Instagram, I highly suggest you follow this Instagram account. Photographer to photographer, there's room at the top for all of us. I definitely want to see everybody win. And if you got the job over me, like, I'm proud of you. So don't do it because you underbid and make it like our job isn't worth the money. We all know we put in a lot of hours. It's not an easy job, okay? So yeah. Guys, I'm almost done. I'm going on my last C, which is choices. Here we go. We're going to talk about what's in my bag.
Okay, so let's talk about what's in my bag. This is what I carry with me for 99% of my shoots. The one exception is game day action, and in that case, I will have a 7200 lens, and I usually use that for the whole game. But currently, I am shooting with the Sony a7 R5. I love this camera, and the lens that's on it is my 2470. I also have a 16-35, which I love, and I have an 85. Those three lenses never leave my bag. I always have a backup camera. Currently, it is my old camera, which is my Nikon D750, but your girl over here is saving for a new Sony, so there we go. I always have my Westcott triggers. Love these guys. I do have a light meter that I rarely use, but I have it in here. Backup batteries, express cards, SD cards. Always have that on hand. And a Leatherman. If you don't have a Leatherman in your life, you need one. Not just for photography, just in life. This is a versatile tool. And when you need one, you have one. So just put it in your camera bag. And that's it, guys. That's what's in my bag.
So this is just a list of the things that I have in my bag, and here are the pictures so you could see them. La la la, blah, blah. I think I spoke with B&H that maybe they're gonna have the links to these things at the end, just so you know what it is that I use. But guys, there's so many more choices and delicious things when we're talking photography, you know? So like, get ready to spend that money. Okay, there's other things too that I do. Hold on, now I gotta go back, right?
Okay guys, so you saw it was in my bag. Now let's talk about what I bring on my shoots. This right here is clutch. This is the FJ400 two light backpack. I have four of them. I absolutely love the flashes, but I love the bag too. I travel with this all the time and it's come clutch. I do have my long fur reflectors. I have my Manny Ortiz beauty dish. I have a couple of 1x3s. I have a portable generator in my car for, you know, when I'm at the field, I want to use the smoke machine and there is no outlets. So I have that. I have a big cart. I actually have two of them to bring all my stuff around. I have my smoke machine, which I will link up there so you guys know what they are. And guys, if you don't own these, they're pretty cool. They're on Amazon and I use them as the weights to hold my stands, which I carry my stands in this. And that's it, guys. That's what I bring on my shoots with me.
All right, and that right here is the list of some of the stuff that I bring on the shoots with me. I put in a workout when I go on these shoots. And I'm just going to make a suggestion for a starter kit because people do reach out to me and like, what should I get if I'm first starting out? And yes, I named it the Mac Pack because I'm Dani Mack. So if you guys want like a little starter kit, the Dani Mack Pack, I would definitely highly suggest the two light backpack from Westcott with FJ400s because it's just such a great deal. You get everything in this backpack. And like I said, on top of like just the Westcott products being amazing, the quality of that backpack, I can't speak highly enough. I literally like want to make an Instagram reel about it being like my best friend coming with me on all of the trips that I've been on lately, all of my travels. It's my companion. I definitely suggest getting the 45 degree deep focus reflectors. I would suggest getting two to start because they are just awesome if you're shooting outside. And obviously, you can use them indoors. And then I would suggest the Manny Ortiz beauty dish because the images that it creates are just yummy and delicious. I don't always use it outside because it could be like it just creates like a sail and the wind can take it. But if you are starting out, it is definitely something that I think you should totally start with. So this is my beginner pack, little Mac pack. And I'll leave you with this. Remember that hard work is a choice. Attitude is a choice. Discipline is a choice. Doing extra is a choice. Excellence is a choice. There are no shortcuts for success. You must work for it. And guys, I live and breathe this business. I definitely have a smile on my face all the time. It's not to say that I don't get stressed out. It's not to say that every minute I'm not thinking about how I'm building this brand. I'm all about it. So just know that it takes a lot of work if you're in it. And with that being said, if you have any questions on future workshops, mentorships, or Westcott gear, you could always DM me on Instagram. Go follow me. You could scan that right there. And yeah, that's it. I'll stop sharing my screen. Oh, selfish plug too, guys. I am offering mentorships if anybody is interested.
Well, how'd I do? You did great. Let's start right there. I mean, people should be investing in their work. This is your passion. This is your livelihood. This is your paycheck. Why not invest in it? And I think you could speak to it. I mean, that was great to see your process. Number one, because photographers just don't show their old work. Everyone's so afraid to do it. Everyone's
out of my old work. I got to tell you this, and maybe this comes with age. I don't know, but you have to cheer for yourself. I actually, somebody once said, if you don't like your photos on Instagram, like be the first like on your, I don't do this and I should, but like, I used to be like that person liked their own picture. Like, that's just so weird, but like make it a habit. If you're not your first, and I'm going to do this, I'm guilty of it, guys, but like, remind me if you don't see that I didn't like my own photo. You should be your biggest supporter. You're in it. This, you're the face of your business. You're the one putting the work out there. And yes, you could be so critical on yourself. And I am super critical. I actually believe those people that are most successful never really feel like they're accomplished. They're always learning and they always want to like take it a step further. And I, hands to like, hand to God, that is me. I will be my worst critic, but I'm also my biggest fan. Like, and the you guys all should, right?
Definitely. Definitely. I mean, I love that you started with the confidence thing, because confidence really does drive everything else. And you learn that you're only hurting yourself. People hate to see a confident person because they're a threat, and that's someone that's going to go out there and they're going to get theirs no matter what. So I think it's great to see you preaching confidence over everything, because that's the only way you get to the next step. Imposter syndrome is only going to hurt you.
Right. And I honestly believe that like, confidence is like one of these, like, it's like like people are offended by it, but they shouldn't be, you know, like you don't want to almost be like, because they're confusing confidence with what being cocky, right? Like, mm-hmm. But they're not the same. They are so not the same. I'm not saying you got to go out there and think you're better than anybody else. That's a cocky person. Being a confident person is saying yes and figuring it out. It's believing that the fact that you could do this, like even on your darkest days, you are planted. Okay, that's it. Just know that it's going to happen. That's it.
I love it. I love it. Well, we have some questions pouring in.
Really?
Yes, we do. So I want to start with high speed sync. Do you use high speed sync when you're photographing?
Yes, of course I use high speed sync. Yes. Okay, so like high speed sync was something that I had to learn. I didn't even know that this existed. Like if you go from like natural light photography to now doing sports photography, yes. To answer that question simply, I love high speed sync, and I use it. Boom.
There you go. Yeah, that is something that you want to get comfortable with, especially practice and go. This is why learning, and this is why workshops, and this is why when you have to be your own model in the backyard or the living room, this is when it really pays off, because you don't want to go out there and have to try to learn high speed sync on the fly, because you're going to fail. It's inevitable. You're going to get the black bars on the side of your image.
I was
and
just going to talk about those black bars. I remember I was like, why is this happening?
Why is it? Yeah.
Why is this happening?
Why is it put in a frame?
Yeah. Like, I don't understand what's blocking this. But listen, that to me was why having a mentor was so important. Like, for me, I am Dani Mack, Dani Mack Photography. It is just me. This is a room in my house. This is my office. All of my stuff is in this room. I can feel very lonely. It can feel very like encompassing, right? But when you have a mentor and you have like another person, or you go to these workshops and you meet other photographers, I talk to other photographers all the time. You're not alone, right? Like no one's sitting there doing the edits with you and all this other stuff. When you have a question or you're wondering why, you don't have to sit there and figure it out on your own. That's why I preach the continued education as part of like, you have to get out there and just be vulnerable to the newness of it. So yeah.
Totally. Question coming in from Vimeo. Do you do meetings with parents and athletes before the shoot day? And if so, what do you talk about at the meeting? I love the workshop. Definitely encourage me to chase my dream job.
Yes. And you should. Okay. So I don't meet like in person with a lot of people, but we're definitely messaging on Instagram. I keep a lot of my business on Instagram. Not necessarily like phone calls or through text messages, because guys, I'm a mom and that life is already so crazy and hectic. So like, I got to keep everything where my business is. Oh, Travis, was that from Travis? He wrote to me, hi. So for me, I don't meet with them, but we do speak ahead of time because I like to know. And I encourage them to send me what they are expecting from the images. Like I tell them to like, look at other photographers' pages, go through my Instagram. Like if I could go into the shoot knowing what they want out of it, it helps. Of course, if they say carte blanche, like, I trust you on this, then I have that in writing.
So, I mean, Travis, we'll open it up with Travis's question. Mentoring, do you do live one-on-one Zoom mentoring or anything like
so
that?
Yeah, so I'm offering Zoom mentoring now, and I'm going to start live mentoring too. So like those that live close to me, if they want to come on a shoot with me, it's fine. I actually, like, I'm just going to give a shout out right now. I know my girl Dina is watching this. Can I just talk about Dina for a second?
Of course.
A year ago, Dina reached out to me asked me if I would teach her. And a year ago, I definitely I had the confidence, but no way would I ever feel like I could teach somebody at that point. I still had learning to do. I literally just picked up my first flash, right? I'm very transparent during all of this. But I work at my craft every day. I'm sharpening my sword. So here we are. And I feel like, yeah, I'm at the point where let's do this. Let's grow together. But Dina had reached out to me, and instead of me saying absolutely not, I actually, I mentioned prior, I do volume, and I had gotten my first big volume shoot, and I had asked her if she was interested, can we meet up? I met her in person. We went to Panera, and I just adored her, and she became my second shooter, and she joins me on a lot of these big shoots as my second photographer. And you know, I walked her through everything, and she will reach out to me with questions, and then she's going through and she's getting a very successful business, and she'll send me some little bits and hey, have you heard of this? And so as a photographer, and she's very close to me, we could be competition, but we're not. Right. And so I love and adore you, Dina, you know that. And we got our big shoot coming up, so let's go, girl. But yeah, so as far as mentorships and stuff like that, that was my first introduction of somebody wanting to learn from me. And I embraced it wholeheartedly. It's a beautiful thing when you can, you know, watch the process, just because I had such a beautiful experience with my mentor and JC and Jean Fruth and Steve Fine. When I went to that workshop at Summit, they didn't just teach, they didn't make me feel like I was one of many photographers. I think there's a revolving door of photographers that probably go through these workshops, right? At any given point in time, there's so many, but they never made me feel like they didn't remember me or my work or didn't speak highly of me. It's very beautiful. So I could talk forever. How long do we have here?
That's great. We love it. We love it. What's the best way to reach out? I mean, we have people writing
Instagram.
In that want to reach
Instagram.
Out. Instagram. There you go.
Yes. At Dani Mack Photography. Dani.
How much do you find with your clients now that want social media stuff? Because you do the reels and everything, which is great. And especially for the kids now, everybody wants this prepackaged content. They don't have to do anything. Are you mixing that in? Is that part of a package, or do you discuss that with them?
Only when parents ask for it will it be a lot of times people are asking for that for a party that they're throwing. Otherwise, right. I'm probably making a reel and then they're just going to share it. But usually for parties, my content's just a little bit longer than it would be on Instagram. But yeah, so I don't promote it as much, because to me, the pressure of making it when it's asked for is different than me just messing around.
Having fun with it.
Yeah, because I don't know if they're going to like the song, whatever, but it's on my Instagram. I'm digging that song, or I'm hitting those words with the different picture. And for me, I do it for me. Knock on wood, it hasn't ever been a problem. But I think when you add the pressure of expectations, it could almost take the fun out of it. And to me, Instagram reels are so fun.
That's a great point. You got to remain passionate about it. And if it's something, you can't take the fun aspect or one fun aspect of your work and your personality and have people clamp down on it and then ruin that for you.
Yeah. Yeah. So I will absolutely hands down do it, but I don't promote that aspect as part of my package deal. You'll get a video too. And I definitely listen, if I could do videography, I would. It's not in my wheelhouse, and it's something that I would love to add on. I've reached out to videographers to try to get them so that we can collaborate. I'm all about everybody winning. So if it's something that sports teams want or parent wants, and you're a videographer and you want to collaborate, I can't wait. I actually have one videographer. I can't wait to work with him. I don't know if he's watching or whatever, but you know, but yeah, I'm open to it.
You never know. You might be sitting here 2 years from now, giving a workshop on hybrid video and stills doing it for sports.
Throw it in the universe. I believe it. Throw it out there. You don't know.
You never know.
Speak it to existence.
I mean, would you have thought 2 years ago that you'd be sitting here doing a workshop online?
When I tell you that I never even saw myself doing this at all, photography, I'm telling you, I took a picture of my dog. I dusted off the camera. I was taking pictures of my dog. I had a camera for so long, but no, I think that this chose me. It saved me. Essentially, it's provided me a beautiful like experiences. I get to meet wonderful people. I'm here with you today. I feel like you ever see that scene in Titanic where they're like, Jack, and like, where are you going next? And he's like, and today I'm here with you, fine people, on the most beautiful ship. And like, no, like, you know, take day by day. Like, you don't know that this is going to happen. And it's a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
Listen, you're going to come across people that are supporters of this. You're going to come across people who are haters of this. They want to know, like, oh, really? Like, whatever. But I ignore all that stuff. I shut that out. I truly believe that like hard work plays pa like a factor in it. Luck does play a factor in it, right? Like, but you have to ultimately put yourself in those situations to be lucky enough to have the opportunity. Okay. Like, I definitely think going to that summit workshop was just like, I was like, okay, I want to go. It's in New York. Let's do this. I would have never imagined that from just going to that workshop that I would meet the most incredible instructors that would lead me to being here with you today, right? I
Yeah.
definitely didn't think reaching out to Brad about the fact that my preset did not make his, my pictures look like his pictures would make him my mentor and help me like learn from scratch of how to do this. And like, he's just been phenomenal in my growth. And that's it. Like, no, I never pictured this,
Yeah,
but am
people
I
love to
so
see
happy?
initiative.
Yeah.
I mean,
Yes.
they want to see that you're if you're invested in yourself, they're not. And this comes, I mentor as well. And who are the people that I leave by the curb? Are the people who they want something for free, they want connections, but they don't want to do the work. And the people that you're willing to go to the edge of the earth for are the people who are willing to go to the edge of the earth for themselves, the people that invest in themselves, they put in the hard work, they're not asking for a handout, they're really just looking to get help. And I think that speaks highly for the type of person you are. And that's why
Thank
you inspire people, because you put in what exactly what you want to get out of it.
you for that. Yes, I honestly like I want people to understand that this is not easy. Like, I don't want to sugarcoat it at all. Like, the smile will always remain on my face, but I live and breathe this. They say that you're married to your business. Like, you're married to it, you're its mother, you're burping it like every moment. Like, I'm not kidding,
Yeah.
because I want this to work so much, but I don't ever want to lose the fact that I want this to be fun. I feel like for me, I was given a second chance at a career and I went through the whole 9 to 5 thing and I was living underneath the rules of somebody else and I had to like just do that. This is my own rules. And if it's just not fun anymore, I don't take that job anymore and it's okay. That's it. And if I'm going to be helping people out, which I genuinely, it's in my core to want to see people like win and do good. Then I'm going to do that. I'm going to do that. But like you said, not if you're not willing to do the work. Okay. You can't tell
Exactly.
me, like, if I was a trainer at the gym, you can't just tell me you want to lose weight and you're not showing up. Okay.
Look, it speaks for itself. You gotta do the work. We're gonna sneak one more question
Okay.
in here for you.
All right.
This is a good one because it does involve children. So we have it looks like an overseas viewer asking, not sure how it is in the states. Do you have to deal with photo consent and release? How is it dealing with parents, especially in this day and age where everything's going to social media, is that something that's discussed, or is there like a
Yes.
no area that you have to stay away from?
Okay, so I always discuss this. I ask all the time if they're okay with being on my Instagram, and they are. Listen, 99% of the time they're reaching out to me on Instagram. Okay, so
Okay.
like chances are that they understand the process that I do. I go on a photo shoot, I take photos, I make a reel, I'm showing behind the scenes, and I'm putting it up and I'm like putting it out there for social media. But I always ask. I always ask. What I will not put out on my social media will be like my volume shoot stuff. Like, that's why a lot of people don't know that I do it, because that's not necessarily consent for those pictures to be used. But if I'm on site for one of my one-on-one sessions or like a team photo shoot, everybody's there. Usually the parents are there. I speak with like whoever booked me. If it's like a team, usually it's like the booster moms, the one mom, or you know, the coach. And I say, like, is everybody cool with me being like posting this stuff on Instagram? And they are. A lot of times I'll start with like a story. Like, I'm just like, hey guys, I'm here with blah, 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 blah. And they're like in it. Like, you know, like
They love
it's
it.
all part of like the process. So, long story short, as far as consent goes, it is definitely spoken about, especially if I'm going to post on Instagram. But I haven't, knock on wood, had an issue with that. So there's that.
Good. Well, Dina sent you some hearts. Mark says, great Dina! Session. DE says, love the idea of a mentorship. We got a lot of great comments in. And Renee says, if you do workshops in New England, please let us know. So you might have to take the show on the road.
Okay. I think we would do good on the road though. Like,
right.
I want to hop in the next, like,
we'll make it a regular thing. I know. Look, come on, get me on the road. Tell JC that JC's got some strings he could pull.
Is he on here? I hope he's watching.
Where is he? We're going to have to harass him and make sure we'll do like a, let's take it to the Southwest. Let's go where the weather's nice. Let's get away from this. It's still not even spring here.
I'm down.
Let's go. There we go.
Say yes and figure it out later, guys.
There we go. Exactly. Figure it out. We're in the business of saying yes. I think that's one of the big takeaways from today. Just say yes. Just do it. You don't know where you're going to be 2 years from now. So why neg yourself? Be your own biggest fan.
Be your own biggest fan.
There you go. I'm going to go like my own pictures on Instagram.
I got to start that too. Listen, this is where like, oh, the preachers, like you're preaching, but you're not practicing what you preach. So hold me to it, guys. I should have put accountability in there, but it didn't start with the letter C. So there was that.
Well, Dani, you knocked it out of the park for the dad joke. There we go.
Where's the Sportraiture?
For Sportraiture, we'll say it one last time, everybody together, Sportraiture. We knocked it out. So, Dani, huge thank you to you. Of course, really? The entire team at Westcott, Mr. JC Carey, the man himself, such a legend. Love that guy.
Brandon, thank you from Westcott. Listen, Westcott's just amazing. I'm going to leave with this because I know we're wrapping up. I told you guys before that I had obviously used different brands and I switched over. So if you are contemplating it and you're on the fence with it, I'm definitely someone you can talk to about it because I do know the financial investment that you just made in the gear. And this comes up from time to time, especially when I'm doing workshops that like, oh, but I already have this. I get it. I totally get it. But it's definitely worth it, in my opinion, to come over to Westcott. And I'm not just saying that because it's Westcott Wednesday. I'm saying, honestly, it's so easy. The interface of their gear is just awesome. It's for the chefs and the cooks.
I love it. For the chefs and the cooks. I'm a cook as well. I got my Westcott kit right here, my studio kit
right
there.
You think you're a cook? I bet you're not.
I'm like world's not best. Wow. That's my confidence speaking. World's worst cook. I make it happen. I make a mean grilled cheese and that's about it.
I love it.
And that relates to photography too. I'm like the grilled cheese cook of photographers.
I say I'm the wings. Like I love me some good wings.
Nice. Everybody loves good wings. There you go. Crispy.
And you can't find them everywhere.
No. It's one of those things you would think you can't mess up until you eat the ones that are like the slimy.
Yeah. And you're like, oh, no.
No. All right. There we go. We got it in the books. Wings, photography, and Sportraiture. Huge thank you to Dani Mack. Once again, go check her out. Dani Mack Photography on Instagram.
Nice.
And one day we'll do this live. We'll do a live little Westcott mock.
We'll do it live.
Or shoot. We'll do it live.
I love that saying.
That's an if you know, you know.
If you know, you know. I say it all the time. So it's so crazy. We'll do it live.
There we go. We'll end on that note with the wonderful Ryan himself. Everyone take care. That's all we got in the books for you today. Another round of the B&H Virtual Event Space in the books for Westcott Wednesday. And everybody out there watching, catch y'all next time.
Bye, guys.